And it's on adding. Unlike fractions. And by what I mean by unlike is I mean fractions with a different denominator. Okay, so let me write the steps out and then we'll talk about how to do it. So as I'm writing the steps, let me write an example so I can start working on the example as I'm writing the steps. So let's say I want to add 2 sevens and 8 over 21. My problem here is that I don't have the same denominator. And the method we learned in the first chapter requires us to have the same denominator. So we're going to follow these rules. So step one is going to be to find the LCD of the fractions. So let's do that. What is the LCD of these two fractions?
73.
What is it?
73.
21. Okay. You can do it and convince yourself that it's 21, but it's 21. Step two. We are going to write each fraction as an equivalent fraction whose denominator is the LCD. Okay, so I want the denominator of both of my fractions to be the LCD. So in the first case, my denominator is 7. I need it to be 21. So how can I write the first fraction as an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 21? Multiply it by what? 3. So this fraction becomes 6 over 21. All right, and the second fraction already has a denominator of 21, so I can keep that one as it is. Then I'm just going to add or subtract the fractions. So how do I add these two fractions with the same denominator? And then finally, I'm going to write in simplest form. Can I reduce that fraction? Okay. Prime factors of 14 are 2 and 7. Prime factors of 21 are 3 and 7. I can cancel out the 7s, and I'm left with 2/3. Okay, let's try one more. So let's say we have 5y over 6 plus 2y over 9. So step one says find the LCD of these two fractions. So what is the LCD of those two fractions? Yeah. And again, feel free to ask me if you need me to actually go ahead and do it. All right, so that's step one. Step two is write each fraction as an equivalent fraction whose denominator is the LCD. So what do I need to multiply the 6 by in the first fraction to get it to be 18? 3. So I multiply this by 3, and whatever I do to the bottom, I need to do to the top. So what does the top become? 15y. Okay, so I took care of the first fraction, now I need to take care of the second fraction. Again, I need a denominator of 18. So what can I multiply that one by?
2.
Yes. What does the top become?
4.
Okay, when I add it together, I'm going to add up the numerators. and keep the same denominator. So what's my final answer? 19y over 18. Good work. So now I want you to try negative 1/5 plus 9 over 20 and B 5/8 minus 1/3 minus 1 over 12. So the last topic we're going to cover in this section is comparing fractions. So let's say I wanted to compare 5/8 and 11 over 20. What are some ways I could compare those two fractions? Or do you think I can just compare them as they are? Yeah?
You have to find the like variables between.
What do you mean the like variables?
Denominators have to be the same.
Yeah. Exactly. So the denominators have to be the same. And that's exactly the point I wanted to get to, is that denominators have to be the same. Because if you look at it, here I have 5 pieces of an 8-piece pie, and you have 11 pieces of a 20-piece pie. But I don't really know which is more. I don't know if it's better to have 5 pieces when it's divided into 8 or 11 pieces when it's divided into 20. So the easiest thing to do is to get the LCD here. So what's my LCD? What is it? 40, right? So the first one becomes, I have to multiply it by 5. So it becomes 25 over 40. And the second one I have to multiply by 2. So it becomes 22 over 40. So now, which one's bigger, the left one or the right one?
Right.
Bigger? So is it better to have 25 pieces or 22 pieces out of the same pie? 25 pieces. All right. They're both divided. No, because they're both divided into 40 pieces, the pieces are all the same size. That's why we got the same denominator, so we could say they're all the same size. It would be different back in this example. Back in here, we don't know how big they are. We just know that this one would be bigger, but we're not sure. Okay, so try this one. Try, if I ask you to compare negative 17 over 20 and negative 4 over 5. Now here, be careful, because we're talking about negative numbers. Remember what happens when we're talking about negative numbers. The numbers closer to 0 are actually the bigger ones. So what's the LCD here? Right, so I can leave the first one the same. First one stays as negative 17 over 20. The first one I need to multiply by 4. It becomes negative 16 over 20. So should I use a less than, greater than, or equal sign here?
Less than,
right? Because negative 16 is closer to 0 than negative 17 is, so negative 16 is bigger.